Shocker.
Yeah.
Whatever the army had planned, their operation had been cut short. The container had leaked. I finally got my sample and a fully fueled ride out of there. The army had planned to wipe out the infection by deploying nukes. The warheads were armed, so I hit the button. I flew for a long time. Everywhere looked the same, a dead world. A secluded underground bunker sounded as good a place as any. After hours of flying, I finally approached the Ego Gate facility. They were probably going to push and prod me for the rest of my life, but I was tired of running and hiding.
So, Mr. McCready, did you get my tissue sample?
Yeah. Here's your sample. Dr. Morden then signaled the lab technicians, and I was ushered into a bio-container, a lot like the one I found Patient Zero in. The doc told me they'd found a way to fuse my DNA with that of Patient Zero's, turning me into a living source for the cure. But I guess that's what they told everyone. There was no cure. I was to become a bioweapon like the others before me, immune to the virus, programmed, obedient. Of course, they didn't know about the cyanide capsule, still hidden inside my mouth. Since I was no good to them dead, I bit down hard. When I flatlined, Dr. Morden rushed to open my container, but he was right. The virus had mutated, and I was no longer immune.